opponents are legal, but no spiking or throws on the head, neck, or spine. One Friday Fights starts now.
From the blue corner, Ismael Khan!
The volcano, Ismael Khan, representing Pakistan from Cax Fight Club, who has had a good string of success this year, 2-0 here on One Friday Fight. They pride themselves on hard work, training from the hills of Islamabad, 1,100 meters above sea level. And that work at the altitude is the reason for their incredible conditioning. They are looking for Khan to continue that momentum here tonight.
I've been looking forward to the return of Ismael Khan for a while, and an impressive debut, winning his first match here with a submission from a rear naked choke. You know, his story, it really is inspiring. Having not getting the support that he wanted, that he needed early on in his fight career, from his family, from the people around him that loved him, he had to show them the hard way, he had to show them through success, and that is where we see him here today, ready to take on the big show.
What a story for Khan. This guy is a wrestler. He's going to use aggressive strikes, such as the overhand right, maybe a leaping left hook, to cut that distance down. And then his game is going to be from the takedown, looking for dominant positions for ground and pound and possible submissions.
The team of Ismael Khan believe that they have a massive experience advantage. Khan, a world bronze medalist in the amateurs, they believe Rabindra has never been tested against a caliber of opponent like Ismael Khan. He showed off his strength and his conditioning and his grappling in that fight against Cho Jun Khan. Ismael Khan ready to make a statement here tonight. Mixed martial arts action in the flyweight division. Can the volcano Ismael Khan make it 2-0 here on One Friday Fight?
From the red corner, Rabindra Dant!
Rabindra Dant, representing Nepal, training on a lock and roll MMA. Rabindra Dant took his talents to a new training camp, the Combat Academy in Nagaland, who Coach DeWiz described as one of the best gyms in India. A new strength and conditioning coach and a nutritionist coming into this one. Dant believes we will see a new and improved version tonight.
The pride and joy of Nepal, Rabindra Dant, coming off an impressive grinding victory in his first outing here at One Friday Fight. And it's that coaching staff that you spoke about, Johnny, that's so fundamental to Rabindra, having started his career with his coach Divis, who actually started grappling here in Bangkok, Thailand, at the infamous grappling gym of Arate, under the tutelage of black belts Andrew MacDonald and Nakahiro Mitsu. These people are the foundation of Rabindra's coach. Divi took this knowledge, took it to Nepal, opened up his own gym, Lock and Roll MMA, and he's able to support people like Rabindra, who have dreams about becoming a champion, support them through their dreams in such a hard place like Nepal.
Not only is he a great grappler, but he's also a great striker. And in this fight, that's going to be his advantage. He's going to want to move, get his jab out there, keep some distance, and look to time strikes as his opponent moves in.
Rabindra Dant versus Ismael Khan to kick off One Friday Fight.
Welcome to One Friday Fight, live from the legendary Lumpini Stadium in Bangkok, Thailand. We begin with 3 5-minute rounds of flyweight MMA. Introducing first, out of the blue corner, training out of Cax Fight Club, holding a mixed martial arts record of 6-0. Representing Pakistan, Ismael the Volcano Khan! And introducing his opponent, out of the red corner, training out of Lock and Roll MMA Nepal, holding a mixed martial arts record of 6-0. Representing Nepal!
Santa. All right, you both understand the rules. Let's keep this clean, keep it active. Obey my instructions at all time. Touch glove if you want. Go back to your corners. Judge time. You ready? You ready? Let's go!
Referee Mohammed Sulaiman in charge of this one. Ishmael Khan in the blue corner. Rabindra Dutt in the red. Both men fighting for a possible $100,000 contract and that invitation into the world's largest martial arts organization, ONE Championship. And a strong start for Ishmael Khan.
Big shots fired at the beginning there. Both of these fighters undefeated. 6-0, equal records. Going to be really interesting to see how this fight moves on.
Yeah, I really like the way that Don was starting with the front kick there. He was throwing the front kick that, you know, is aimed at the body. But what he can do with that is very sneakily bring it up under the chin. It's a sneaky technique, and it speaks to his skill set on his feet.
Speaking to Rabindra Dutt, the game plan was to be like water. He wants to take this fight everywhere he goes. He spoke about the strong grappling prowess of Ishmael Khan. Rabindra Dutt says, my grappling is just as good.
Controlling the double underhooks here. Good control from Rabindra. And nice turn of the corner with a Kosaka Dagaki. And he gets right on top to the full mount. It's going to be really interesting to see if he can get good control with the hips. There you see him lowering his hips, trying to get better control. He's going to need to be careful because Khan knows what he's doing on the ground, but a nice control there by the neck. Trying to land some significant ground and pound with the grappling prowess of Dunk. Really showing that.
Excuse me, Achilles. This is where Rabindra Dutt does his best work. Five KOs by ground and pound. This is not where Ishmael Khan wanted to be.
A good stand up there from Ishmael Khan. Able to come up on a single leg here. With the head on the outside, it's going to be difficult to finish it. But he manages to stick the corner here. If he could just get to the right angle, he might be able to get some hooks in here and control the back a little bit better, because Rabindra Dutt definitely knows what he's doing in this position.
I like how Khan was really patient on the ground there. He didn't lose control, and he stuck with the single leg, and now he's in a dominant position. That was really good work for Khan.
Both men had a perfect 6-0. Massive opportunity for them to continue this winning streak. Consistent dominance in ONE Friday fights is crucial for that invitation into ONE Championship. Both men already one win apiece here inside this legendary Lumpini Stadium.
These are the types of grappling exchanges that can just be crawling in a matchup, really tested the athlete's cardio. And a nice takedown there attempt from Khan, unable to keep Dunn on the ground. Back to the feet they are.
Yeah, this is one of those gridlocked positions where you just have to fight it out. There's going to be a lot of scrambling. And you know, to win and come out on top, it's going to take a lot of stamina.
As we expected, a grappling heavy battle inside this first round. Rabindra Dutt trying to keep Ishmael Khan off him. Goes to the tie plum and a nice knee to the body there by Rabindra Dutt. But a takedown attempt here from Ishmael Khan. Drops him to the ground.
Nice double leg takedown. Let's see if Khan can progress his position here, get some dominant control, possibly inflict some damage with some ground and pound.
Khan is being really patient, working his way up slowly to achieve that dominant position. And to see him throw a little bit more of his left and right hand as he moves in, throw Dutt off a little bit.
Changing camp for Rabindra Dutt, who took his talents to Nagaland. A new strength and conditioning coach and a nutritionist. A nice right hand there by Rabindra Dutt. And a response there from Ishmael Khan. What a battle we have to start. Mixed martial arts action inside the flyweight division. Rabindra Dutt from Nepal, Ishmael Khan from Pakistan.
Big shots thrown by Rabindra, trying to let Khan know that he means business.
We're seeing that front kick again. It's really effective. And the thing is, Khan's got to be careful that he doesn't just get too complacent with eating it on the body, because that thing can go upstairs really fast. Those body shots are really effective. They stick with you the whole fight.
I said that this would be an opportunity to showcase more of his striking. A Ismail Khan on the other side showcasing some fluid combinations himself.
The kind of hardships that both of these fighters have been through in life is definitely the kind of motivation that puts them through such a grueling round that we've seen so far. As Ismail Khan unloads in the corner to end the first round in a flurry. And what an excellent exchange by both competitors.
Strong finish to the round by Ismail Khan, but back and forth it was. Both men tried to keep that perfect undefeated record.
That's going to be difficult to do in this one. And here you see in the first round, after the successful takedown there, you see the knee to the solar plexus from a dirty box in the inside. Really forcing the dogfight in this one.
Both of these guys are showing some really good striking here and attacking the body. You hurt the body, the hands come down, your opponent gets tired, it creates openings. Really great for both of them.
Ravindra Dhan, who not long ago had to work odd jobs while sustaining his professional career.
Let's go!
Now finds himself one win already inside of one Friday fight. Can he take out a very tough Ismail Khan?
Ismail Khan coming out in the second round. Really aggressive.
Yeah, like the tenacity from Khan, but he's got to set those shots up. He just dove in for the legs there. And Dhan is so good, he's going to be able to stuff that. Now you're back in this position where you're using a lot of energy and flying for dominance.
This is what Ismail Khan spoke about. He says that Ravindra Dhan has never faced the level of opponent as himself, but Dhan showing us that full skill set. Another big takedown here inside the second round. Moves himself right to mount.
That was a lovely single leg takedown. Progress straight into the mount. A very dominant top position here. As we saw him do in the first round, but this time he makes a small change and he's able to take the back. He's now got one hook in. If he can get good enough control, he might be able to start initiating some submissions. But good defense from Ismail Khan. Now he takes the back. This really is an exciting back and forth.
Great back and forth from both fighters. They're staying patient. They're working from those dominant positions. They're both so good that it's going to be a lot of back and forth action like this.
One Friday fights is the platform for most established fighters and up-and-comers who want to earn a shot at the highest levels in the world in the flagship world championship. Dante Khan fighting. Oh, hungry for that spot.
Big knee from Dhan caught on the chin by Khan as he ends up on top here. Can he progress to a better position? Dante's going to need to start working off his side. He's going to have any chance of getting up.
Khan, I really like what he's doing here in the second round. He had his opponent cornered there before the takedown. He threw the elbow, he threw the uppercut. He's letting his hands go a little bit more now.
Non-stop transitions on the ground in the second round. Ismail Khan floating on top. Oh, possible attempt at the arm triangle choke, but now goes back to softening the body of Ravindra Dhan.
I'm sure Ravindra Dhan's been here many times before. He's gonna have to use the right technique to get out of this one. Ismail Khan has come out in the second round like a man on a mission, trying to finish this fight. As he moves back into the mount here, good defense from Ravindra Dhan.
Insane toughness shown by Ravindra Dhan, but Ismail Khan goes on the hunt again. A rear naked choke attempt.
And if you roll with any of the guys from Rock and Roll MMA, you know that there's savages on the ground. Ravindra Dhan is going to have to take a lot more to try and take this man out. But good work so far from Ismail Khan.
Props to Dhan for keeping his composure there, staying relaxed, and he was in a couple bad spots, but he's still in the fight.
Ismail Khan on the offense again. The arm triangle attempt, rear naked choke attempt. He's trying to put away Dhan, but the toughness of the Nepali Dhan on full display.
The toughness is what's keeping him through this right now. He needs to focus on his countering, his transitions, because right now he's only defending. It it's that momentum change that he needs to look for in the grappling exchanges. Otherwise, he's going to be constantly defending with his shoulders with the mat, just like you're seeing right now.
The judges see this, and it's all Khan. He's not using a lot of energy. He's just like a wet blanket on top of Khan, shutting everything down, just keeping the dominance throughout this round.
Ishmael Khan trains on the hills of Islamabad. High altitude work. They have spoken about this in the interviews. They believe that this would be the separator, the conditioning, the pace. Pedro Dan having to overcome this pressure now in the grappling department from Ishmael Khan.
Really has been one-way traffic so far in this second round. Well done, he's done well to defend the onslaught grappling attacks of Khan. Like we said earlier, he's going to need to do something drastic to change the momentum. And there you have a big knee to the face, which Dunn just wipes off with no emotion.
The grind from Khan, it's not any particular strike, it's the accumulation and it's the pressure that is getting the Dunn.
Domination on the ground inside the second round. For the athlete representing Pakistan, Ishmael Khan.
Big turn of the tide here in the second round. Clear domination, as you see, for the Pakistani athlete, Ishmael Khan. There you see the nice knee up the middle there from Dunn, just to keep Khan humble. But that would not stop his relentless, non-stop attack in this second round so far.
Khan is just getting more and more comfortable. He's in his rhythm, he's grinding, he's pressing, he's really driving in and making Dunn uncomfortable. Not want to be there.
Let's go, seconds up, please.
What an honor to witness mixed martial arts action inside this legendary Lumpini Stadium. Both men battling.
Turn around, blue.
For the possibility of a six-figure, $100,000 contract.
Ready, let's go.
The invitation into one championship. Ishmael Khan with a strong second round. And he looks to follow it up. What a head kick.
And a good counter there. But Dunn searching for the takedown with the high crunch. But Khan just one step ahead there.
Something very telling there right before the round started. You can see the look on Khan's face. He looks relaxed. He looks happy. He's having fun. He's in that flow state right now. This match, he's really channeling his skill set.
Ishmael Khan continues his grinding approach. Pushing down to the ropes, but a nice turn there. Rabindra Dunn, what can he do inside this final 4 minutes and 10 seconds. He needs a big third round here, boys.
He's gonna need to switch it up with the takedowns here. Khan's got the read on him. He's pushing with the double underhooks here. He's turned the corner. That's what we mean when we say thinking ahead. Dunn right now, he's gone back to defending. Good turn of the corner there from Khan. The ropes helping Dunn a little bit there.
Tied up in the ropes there. Yeah, Dunn by no means is out of this fight, but he needs to make some space. He's gonna need a big shot or a big submission out of nowhere to turn this thing around.
Ishmael Khan looking to make it 7-0 inside his professional career.
Good turn there from Dunn. Let's see if he can make something happen here. Really threatened Ishmael Khan. Right now, it looks like Khan is just happy to do the same thing that he did in round two. Like we talked about, keep that constant pressure, that constant strategy of attack, and run away with this victory.
Both fighters are showing incredible conditioning and heart at this moment. What Dunn needs to do is get some distance and let some strikes go. If it stays like this, Khan is just going to walk away with the win.
Global rules, mixed martial arts. This bout will be judged as a whole, not round by round. So think of this as a 15-minute, one big round. Do you think it's done the better body or what? Ishmael Khan with the pressure. Dunn with the first big round, the two round attempts, but you have to take into account that a head and arm attempt, the rear naked choke attempt, should score heavily in the eyes of the judges.
Oh, and a nice finish there on the single leg from Khan. sitting here staying in the half guard. And again, we see this position so much in MMA, the half guard, able to control from the top and learn strikes. And there you see Khan suffering up down, possibly trying to get an opening for a submission here.
Don needs something big. He needs to, whatever he's got left in his gas tank, empty that thing, make some space, and let his hands go.
Long stop action here. Ismail Khan, short strikes. Trying to take the path of Don, but Don wrestles him down to the ground, holding on to that single leg.
Oh, and a nice pull there. Coming up. He's going to need to look up to contain with his knees. Because if Don escapes from here, he's going to end up in a good position from the top.
Ismail Khan looking to attack the armbar.
And patience here from Ismail Khan. Again, this is MMA. You can't strike from the top here with the knees. Good tactics so far from Don. He still needs to be careful. Just with that cut in there with the armbar, there's extra leverage, especially if you're going to get a good angle and extend from here.
100%. Sometimes going for a submission can really be a gamble. And Don did a great job of staying up, picturing up, and then using what was available, that knee, and dropping him in the head. I'm shocked that Don's not covering.
Knees to the head of grounded opponents are legal here. And the one roots in, and Don able to use it to his advantage, now ends up on top. Less than a minute to go. Can Rabindra Don from Nepal make something happen?
Big elbow from the top. But Khan doing all the right things to defend here. Turning the corner nicely. Trying to come up on the leg as he did before. We've just got to be careful here. But Khan doesn't take his back.
These guys are still setting the fight. They're just flying through position. Don really needs a hit maker here. Pull this thing out.
10 seconds left here. Might get lucky and see something happen off the break. But Ismail Khan, happy to take this victory in a grueling three-rounder. Still going to have to wait for the referee's decision. But rounds two and three, looking quite grim for Rabindra Dutt.
Rabindra Dutt and Ismail Khan go all three rounds. As we expected, it was a grueling battle. Ultra tight here. Take us through the action here, Achilles.
There you see the story of the second round here. Short shots landed on the ground. This was a good submission attempt from Ismail Khan, heavily defended from Rabindra Dutt. The dead legs, the Charlie horses, as the Americans say. Those were haunting Don all fight long.
Don did a great job, but Khan just really took advantage of those key moments.
Key moments they were. Going to be interesting to see this decision. If Khan did enough in rounds two and three, it looks like it might go his way. Let's hand it over to Nara for the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. All three judges have called this contest in favor of your winner by unanimous decision, Ismail Khan!
The volcano Ismail Khan improves the record to 7-0 with the unanimous decision victory over Rabindra Dutt. Was the grappling, the pressure, the pace, and the conditioning that picked him up. Victory number two.